some minutes I had lost my bowel control, I had lost my urine control, and I crashed on the floor with a severe back pain. I was not even in a position to be even picked up and taken to the hospital. So I landed up in the hospital the next day, where the MRI scan showed that I'd broken my L4, L5 disc. Broken means it is completely broken. And the doctors told me that I have to go in for an emergency surgery, or else I would be paralyzed for the rest of my life. I went in for a surgery, not knowing what was going to really happen. The surgery did not go well, and I ended up with a CSF leak, a cerebrospinal fluid leaking right from my brain down into my spine like a waterfall and coming out from the place where I had my surgery. So I had this whole fluid that had got collected in the place of my surgery. It was like as though I was carrying a lemon on my lower back. And every time this would get pressed, the fluid would rush back to the brain, giving me a seizure, and I would be completely unconscious within a few minutes. And when I would regain my consciousness, I had no idea of what had happened. And the only solution that my doctor could give me was another surgery. Thank you so much. I said, how are you going to find this place from where this fluid has leaked? He said, I will inject a dye in you, and wherever the dye comes out, we'll try and seal that area. And even though I wasn't a very good student in my school days, I had a fair idea of what the nervous system was. And I was wondering out of all those nerves, which nerve is he going to find and plug it? And I think I took my bravest decision that day and I told him, back off. He said, you can go into coma, your heart may collapse, you may get paralyzed for the rest of your life. And I said, it doesn't matter. For 1.5 years, I struggled with seizures, trying to find an answer as to what can be done so that this leak could stop, this bubble would disappear, and I could go back to being normal. It had affected my life very badly. I couldn't walk, I couldn't sit, I couldn't sleep on my back. I had to be very careful even at night when I used to sleep. I had to keep a pillow, sleep on one side and keep a pillow so I wouldn't become straight. Because otherwise in my sleep, I would get a seizure. And that is where I realized that I was in an absolute hypervigilant mode constantly, because I had to see to it that I don't get a seizure. And all the time, there was only one question in my mind: what do I need to do? And that is when the book, You Can Heal Your Life, came in my life. Again, there are no coincidences. It just came as a gift to me. I started reading that book, and I started following the principles in that with the help of a psychologist. That's okay. Hello. With the help of a psychologist, and within 3 months of releasing my anger, my fear, my leak had completely stopped. The fluid got back into the brain. And that is the next scan which proves that I don't have it anymore. I wanted to actually share that during the panel discussion, but I said, no, I might as well do it during my talk. So this was my journey in that 1.5 year of finding my answers. And that is when I started searching for answers. You Can Heal Your Life came in my way. Then came Bowen therapy, which helped me strengthen my muscles, my nerves, got me back walking. Absolutely fine, where I could not even stand for 5 minutes. Today I can work continuously for 18 hours and no worries at all. Thank you. And then Metta came in my life, which gave me the answer to the questions as to why this has happened. Can anybody give me a little insight about what could have happened to me? Yes, of course, because it was to do with my spine, my lower back, there was no support at all. I've never been supported by my parents, never been supported by my ex-husband. So my spine was obviously very weak. And again, as a behavioral disorder say, it was always my fault. It was always my fault if my father didn't approve of me, if my mother didn't approve of me, or whatever. And that fight just broke that support completely. Now, unfortunately, what had happened was in the hospital that I was, before they took me for the surgery, they had stripped me completely. And they just put a bedsheet over me. And they took me from my room till the operation theater in that condition. And I have a history of child abuse from 12 to 18. So I was in absolute terror of what was going to happen to me. I think more than the surgery, I was scared of what would happen to me in this situation. And just before the anesthesia was given to me, I heard one of the persons say, "Roll her off properly, she's not wearing anything." And that is where the fear got so intensified, and I completely went into that state of fear when the anesthesia was given to me. When I got out of the surgery, I had fever. Because I saw myself at least alive, I knew I was okay. And with that fever came severe headaches. The doctors just couldn't understand why the headaches were there. It was later when the scan was done, it was because of this. So that is where Meta helped me put that whole story together. I worked on my abuse a lot after that, on my fears and my self-evaluation. I know we are not supposed to use the word self anymore, but it had to do with a lot of evaluation where I was not feeling valued, where I was not valuing even myself. And then I brought this whole thing together, Heal Your Life, Inner Child Work, Bowen Therapy and Meta, and this is how I work today. For example, if a client comes to me with acidity, as per Meta, we know what is the cause. Anybody, what is the cause for acidity? It's a huge amount of anger that is suppressed, in very simple terms if we were to put it, right? And what happens is that once I identify the trauma that causes the acidity, I look for the emotional charge in the body. Because many times the clients don't know, where is my stomach, where is my liver? So I tell them, just answer one question. How does it make you feel when you have this acidity? And that is how I start my conversation with them. Once that is done, I create a safe place for them to do the therapy. Creating a safe place is extremely important because I realize that when people are going through trauma, they do not have a safe way of dealing with it. And so I create that safe place for them so that they can openly finish what they couldn't finish at that time. When we talk, they start talking to me. Obviously, it breaks the isolation. So they come down out of the udin. The udin is not there anymore because they feel safe to talk. They feel safe to express. And once that is done, I ask them, what was it that you couldn't do at that time? And they have a list of things like, I was frozen in fear. I could not express myself. I had suppressed a lot of anger. I was feeling helpless, anything. And then with the therapy, I helped them finish that thing that was incomplete. I gave them a safe way of releasing their anger, which could be by beating up pillows, creating a mannequin that they can beat up, anything that could get that anger out. I make them go through that fear in that safe place, which brings them out of that freeze. I let them express themselves fully and completely to all those people where they could not express, and how the whole healing process gets completed. And once the therapy is done, I give ongoing support with the help of affirmations and Bowen therapy. Bowen therapy helps their bodies to remain in balance while they are going through the healing crisis. And affirmation helps to fill up that part of them which they had lost during the trauma. So in case if it is it's a case of acidity, I would give them a simple affirmation like, it is safe to express your anger. And when they're continuously doing this affirmation, they realize that it's okay to be angry. All I need is a safe way of being able to let go of that anger. Okay, now since we don't have enough time, I had actually planned a small exercise and then a whole affirmations. So Anu, how do we go about it? Oh, okay. I think I breezed through quite fast. So I just hope everybody understood at least what I'm doing. Any questions? Any questions? Just a second. I'm sorry.
When you were talking, you said something about how would you identify why this happened to you. You said something like that.
Yeah.
So the point I'd like to just to stress on is that...
I'm sorry, I'm not being able
just
to hear.
Like, just like we have the mind, the soul, you know, the heart, the emotion, and the physiological
yes.
aspects of our entity, of our physical body. Just like that, we have an intelligence which is mental, emotional, and also biological. The body has its own intelligence.
Yeah.
I mean, so when you address, like you say, affirmation, when you address the issue to the brain, I'm talking about it like different entities, like the mind talking to the brain
yeah.
and the emotion talking to the brain. When you tell the brain that this is the problem, identify where this ailment to you in your spine, the brain knows exactly where it is.
And I think that is how, the exercise that I will make you do now, that should answer that question to
yeah,
you.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Okay, everybody just keep everything that you have on one side. And if possible, feet on the ground. And just close your eyes. And start taking some nice deep breaths. Breathe in clean, clear, light energy. Relax and exhale. Breathe in clean, clear, light energy. Relax and exhale. Breathe in clean, clear, light energy. Relax and exhale. And now very gently, take your attention to that part of your body that feels uncomfortable or is in pain. Very gently take your attention to that part of your body. Imagine that this part of your body can speak to you. Ask this part of your body, what is the problem? What is the emotion that is stuck over there? Allow that part of your body to answer you. Now ask that part of your body, what can I do to release this discomfort? What can I do so that you can feel better? Now breathe into the center of your chest, there your heart chakra is. It is an infinite well of love. And from that part of your heart, imagine this energy flowing into your hands. And if you can touch that part of your body which was in discomfort, gently put your hand over there. And if you cannot imagine your loving hand over there, and now send lots of love to that part of your body. With every breath, send lots of love to that part of your body. Feel the discomfort becoming less. Feel it become lighter, healthier. Keep talking to that part of your body. It will give you all the information that you need. Just be willing to listen. And tell yourself, I love you. I really, really love you. Take a nice deep breath. Feel yourself back. And with another nice deep breath, then you feel ready. Very slowly open your eyes. So did you all get any answers? Dr. Kwesi is nodding. Anybody else? Does that answer your question? Thank you. So I think this is one of the most simplest ways of getting an answer. Even if you don't know anything, just talk to your body. It will give you the answers. And coming back to affirmations, as to what are affirmations, and an affirmation is anything that you say and think continuously. Doing affirmation means deliberately choosing words and thoughts that will help what you want or release unwanted experience from your life. An affirmation can be used in any area of your life. And now I want you to play a small piece of music, which is an affirmation music, just to make you realize how affirmations work. Normally, I tell all my clients, sing your affirmations, dance your affirmations, read your affirmations, whatever. Just have fun with it. And that's exactly what we are going to do, is we are going to have fun with affirmations. Everybody ready for that? Would you like to stand up? Joy fills up. And the words are very simple. It is something that Dr. Kwesi has been saying from the last 4 days. We are whole, perfect, and complete.
Every cell in my body, every cell is alive with love. I relax into the healing process. I allow spirit to do what it does.
Get the words.
Joy fills every cell in my body. Every cell is alive with love. I relax into the healing process.
Just close your eyes and allow these words to seep in.
Joy fills every cell in my body. Every cell. Spirit to do what it does. Peace fills every cell in my body. Every cell is alive with love. I relax into the healing process. I allow spirit to do what it does.
God, come on, move it.
Spirit to do what it does. Spirit to do what it does. Joy fills every cell in my body. Every cell is alive with love.
Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you so much.
The healing process.
All healing energy flows through me now.
Kavita, please come.
Harmony, balance, vitality.
So today,
that glorious wisdom that creates and sustains health is mine.
And
I live in divine well-being now and always.
Conference next year, and I'm going to say later where it is, then you are going to become a master trainer.
Thank you, Anand. Thank you so much.